Hey y'all, it's Jeff Wiseman, and I'm going to show you. Some of you have seen this. Many of y'all have had these. I'm going to show you how to make the best margarita that you've ever had at home. Okay, the secret to this whole thing with the margaritas is we're going to end up making 6.5 liters. That's what this makes. But this right here is a secret to the whole recipe. And I'll put this in the description or details down below in the video. It's Lasco's, or Lasco if you're from Texas, Lasco's Lime Cocktail Mix. It is a 34-ounce bag. You can get this locally in Houston at the Spec stores. I'll carry them. And if you're not in Houston, good luck finding this. I'm in Utah now. Could not find it anywhere in the state or next to me states. So luckily Specs is big enough now to where I was able to order this directly off the internet. And I ordered like 5 bags of these. I want to say these bags are under $10 a piece. I can't remember the exact numbers, but they're under $10 a piece. This is the secret to it. Without this, you can try to substitute anything else, it's not going to work. So, as much as I'm talking about how good these margaritas are, while I'm making them, I might as well have a margarita from my last batch that I made a few months ago. You're going, margaritas from a couple months ago? Yeah. It's cool. It makes 6.5 liters of margaritas, and you can bottle it up and refrigerate it in the containers that they come out of, and I promise you, it is still good. So, that's another benefit of it, is you can store it, keep it in your garage refrigerator, or whatever. Tastes just like as if I made them today. Okay. Back to the ingredients. Lasco's Lime Mix, 34 ounces. Tequila, one, as in a single bottle of a 1.75 liter tequila. Because this is the secret, you don't need expensive tequila. You don't need the good tequila. This is what's making the taste. From here on out, it's just about filling in the ingredients and the alcohol content to make a good margarita. This video might take a while now. So I normally buy the Montezuma's Aztec Gold. The original recipe given to me by Kirk the Margarita Man with Skydive Houston. He used clear. It's just a taste preference. If you can tell the taste difference, try it either way. I don't think it matters. I just like the gold. It's got a little more of a tequila taste than the clear. So, cheapest tequila 1.75 you can find. Then you need the cheapest Triple Sec, a single 0.75 liter. Now be careful when you go shopping for Triple Sec. A lot of the bottles are gonna be single liters, which is 0.25 liters more than you need. You could put it all in there. You could save it for the next batch and put it on your bar or whatever, but you only need slash want a 0.75 liters of Triple Sec. Again, get the cheapest stuff you can. Next, another secret, don't ask me why, I just accept the fact that that's what it is and I do it. 2.75 liters of club soda, cheapest you can get. And that's it. Except, we're gonna also add another 2 liters, same size as this, of just plain water. We mix it all together, put it in bottles, serve it up. So luckily, you get to watch me mix it. Here's what I do. I learned this from Kirk also, the margarita man. It's an igloo 3-gallon container with a pour spout. Perfect for parties. You set it up on the edge like that and let people drink out of it. Give them a red Dixie cup. That's all we ever did. So, let's make a batch. If it gets long, I'll edit this out. Start out with the Lasco's lime mix. Put that in there first. And if you want to know what's in this, you gotta read the label. Cause I'm not, cause I don't care. I've had these margaritas, they're good. It might be liquid crack, it might be powdered crack cocaine. Next, doesn't matter what order you do this in. And then save these bottles because we're going to reuse them. So 0.75 triple sec. Save the top, don't lose anything. A lot of tequila, huh? Putting a lot of water in there too, and soda. Take the slow pour thing out of there. Tequila. Seriously, at this point, all I can smell is the mix. The tequila is overpowered by the mix. Until you start drinking it, and then it's like, woo! Save the bottles. Next, open this slowly. Liters club soda. And next we got one more ingredient to put in there, and that's the water. How much water? Another 2 liters. Use this good old reverse osmosis water. Tap water is fine too, because the secret is the Lasco's. It's the lime mix. That's the secret. Cinco de Mayo in a week. Two liters. That's the secret recipe. If you ever skydive at the old Skydive Houston, then you know these very well. Oh, now what am I doing now? I got me a little stir stick because you gotta stir up all that powder. This might take several minutes, but that's all mixed, so that didn't take too long. Now what I did, in anticipation of the video and the prep, I saved up an empty 2-liter Dr. Pepper, so I will have 1, 2, that much full of margaritas to be taken to the party. 5.75 plus another 0.75, 6.5 liters of margaritas. I'm wondering if that's going to be enough for the party. I might need to make another batch. Probably will. So I've already had one. I got to let you know this one secret. It's not a secret, it's a tip, and you'll figure it out on your own. Lasco's lime mix is mostly sugar. So that's 34 ounces of sugar. These are very sticky if you spill them. So as soon as you're done making them, rinse off the bottles, dry them off, rinse out your container and the floor and everything else you've made a mess with. And if you're out at a party and you spill it, it's gonna get sticky. See what I mean? I think I forgot what I was going to say. Oh yeah. It takes a while to clean this up. But I made a mess. But the thing to do is, while you're making the margaritas, you got to test them. Because if there's something wrong with them or bad, you want it to happen to you. Meaning me. So you want to test them all. You want to test all the bottles. Now it's all the same stuff coming out here. But after you, it takes a while to clean it up. I mean, to get it right and dry it up in your kitchen. And so anyways, I guess what I was, oh yeah, I know what I was gonna say. This is the first review of these margaritas. My review is, they taste like good margaritas. They get you drunk. And they'll probably get her to take her panties off. Alright, you can't say that. Margaritas have a lime taste. They're tart. You can't taste the alcohol, which is good. And no shit. These seriously are about the best margaritas you can make for $40. I remember back when we were making them at the drop zone, they were like $25 a batch. But alcohol's gotten more expensive, or I don't know. What am I talking about? Let's go get some real reviews from some girls. Let's go. Everything's cleaned up. See it. So these things do make a mess. Well, I think my floor might have been messy before. But you know what? These margaritas, they're fun to make. Shit. Just make sure you make them at home. And you sample them at home. It's Jeff Wiseman with a public service announcement. The margaritas are good. Don't drink and drive with them. Because if you spill it, these things will be really sticky. You have a hard time. Really hard time. Cleaning it up your car.